Hey, everybody. Hello.
Hi.
Welcome to Alive.
Cheers. Where's your drink?
I'm not drinking.
Oh, are you like one of those like don't drink in January?
No, I was so hungover yesterday. Like,
oh, okay,
I need a break. No, I could never do sober January.
Yeah, those are for quitters.
Yeah, I give those people credit, I guess.
Yeah.
So welcome to the live.
Thank you. So excited. Wait, are you okay that we're like horizontal? Do you see us, or is
yeah,
that
we see you?
Okay. Okay.
So what have you guys been up to? It's been what, like 13 years since the show aired?
That makes us sound so old. I think like 11.
I'm sorry.
I think like 11 years. Yeah.
11. Oh, okay. I was thinking like season 1 and 2.
Oh yeah.
Wait, so do we have to read these? Okay.
Well, you can if you want, but I also,
we're both turning our heads sideways to read them because we're if we have anything in our teeth, we were just eating Mexican food.
Yeah,
so sorry.
Please tell us.
No problem.
So what have we been up to?
Yeah, what
do you... Like today or in like the last 11 years? How much time do you have?
I want a rundown of every day the past 11 years.
Well, Cami has a baby.
She's going to be
a beautiful baby.
Oh, yeah, I've seen pictures. She's so cute.
Thank you. She'll be 3 February 15th.
Awesome.
And we're pretty sure that she's mine, that I just didn't have to have labor pains.
We scrambled
she carried the baby for me.
We scrambled our eggs.
She's a really good friend.
What do you guys do for work? You're what, traveling, Kyndra? Is that what you're doing?
Oh, I wish. That sounds like a wonderful job.
I don't know.
No, I've been in fashion for pretty much my entire adult life, so I'm still in fashion.
Okay.
I'm really enjoying, you know, the whole like blogger kind of thing. I'm kind of trying that out right now. It's a little bit different. But yeah, I've like shop. My problem is I shop when I'm happy. I shop when I'm sad. I shop when I'm like, you know,
so it's a real problem.
I'm just trying to turn it into like something other than, you know, a budget issue.
Yeah, no, I get that.
A bad credit score.
Yeah.
I have to say it's impressive. You went from like 2,000 followers to being verified and like 8,000 followers.
Oh, well, thanks. Laguna Beach is the number one fan. And you're tracking it, girl.
You're not tracking it. I'm like, when is she going to accept me?
Oh, I know. I'm sorry. I love that you're like, it was Hunger Games. I'm like, oh, gosh. Only no, I just was never really big into like the social media thing until recently.
Yeah.
So sorry to keep you in purgatory for that long.
It's okay. I understood it, so.
So what are these people asking?
I don't know. Most people are just saying how excited they are.
Oh, good. Us too. Why didn't we do... Wait, turn the phone at a different angle. Okay, so let's
see. Okay, so let's do this. Give us a sec.
Yeah, no problem.
Can you unplug it?
Yeah. Wait, you're going to die when you see... Like, look at this situation. I've got, like, a selfie stick here.
Oh, I need one of those.
It's like a tripod type. Okay. Let's see. You ask and we deliver. Is that better?
That's perfect.
Okay. Well, you guys all saw what happened there.
Since we were 11.
Yeah.
So I have a question for you guys. So I didn't watch season 3 until literally like Christmas. One of my followers bought me season 3 and they're like, you need to watch it. You need to
watch it.
You can still buy it?
Yeah. You can buy it off iTunes.
So oh, that's horrible.
That is bad news. Don't tell anyone else. No one listen.
But like, so season 3 to me seemed a little more scripted and like production was more involved. Is that, would you?
Yeah, I think that like season 1 and 2 happened so organically. And I think at season 3, it was like, they really were trying to control what the viewer's perspective was of.
Yeah.
With us. I think where we were like really frustrated, and I don't want to speak for Cami, but like we didn't, what you saw was so not like the reality of what was happening.
Yeah.
So I think that was really hard. Like, we never even really met Raquel until she showed up at the house, and we never had a problem with her, but it was, like, really created around that.
Yeah.
I think it's definitely, like, whatever worked for season 1 and 2, they sort of tried to, like, peg-hole us into those spots, like, those, like, the character spots, and that's not necessarily, like, how we are and we were also 16. I think everyone at this age, I think, has grown up quite a bit.
Yeah.
And at 16, when you're filming for 9 months, they're not going to catch your best moments and what they think is going to fit into that role of like the mean girl or whatever it is.
Yeah.
They're going to show because that's what they thought.
And there's only like one thing like worse than having a 16-year-old in front of a camera, and it's like a 16-year-old that's pregnant in front of a camera. Like, so like any 16-year-old or 17-year-old, it's, you can't expect right. a good result. But I think for us, the editing really kind of sucked for our season.
Yeah, I'd say so. You guys, I feel like it's so unloved. And I was one of those. I'm like, I'm not going to watch it. Then I did. And I'm like, wow, I'm actually kind of sad there's no season four. Like, so
yeah,
longer.
There's a lot being done differently. Well, and we always talk because we had so many different like memories of filming and like had the funniest things that have happened and none like really actually made it to the show. Mm-hmm. So we want like, okay, what like was left on like the editing, you know,
on
the floor. Yeah. That like we would actually want like, and think that it'd be funny for people to watch.
Yeah. Did you guys expect there to be a season four? Or just
no, towards the end, we kind of had this feeling after it had already aired and we saw the episodes. We're like, you know, to be honest, like our season was not as good as 1 and 2. It was, yeah. We weren't even expecting. I mean, even just the storyline itself seemed super like forced.
Yeah. Yeah, I'd agree with that. And like you guys had your funny moments and stuff. I'm like, wow, they actually seem funny. Like they don't seem bad.
No, we thought we were really funny.
We thought that was the problem. We thought we were probably too cool then.
So did you know you were going to be,
oh my God, wait, somebody asked about how bad it hurt when I ran into the tennis pole. Can we have a moment for that? Because that actually, and I don't know if anyone knows, that popped my appendix.
Oh my God.
Yes. And okay. So it punctured my appendix. So it hurt like a bitch. And the embarrassment was like 10 times worse of like having your butt on national television. And I think we were in New York watching that at TRL, like when TRL was a thing.
Okay.
And watching that in Times Square was, you know, ultimate embarrassment. But then like months later, my appendix ruptured and it was because of an injury, and that must have been the injury.
That's insane.
I agree.
But it was still funny regardless.
Yeah.
Worth it.
So do you guys know you're going to be on season 3? Because you're both in season 2 a little bit.
Yeah, I think that maybe just being like filming a little bit, I think, on season 2, and the producers are such a small high school too. I think almost naturally they're like, maybe that was kind of like their lead in to season 3 was like that maybe Ken mm-hmm. and I were on it a little bit. So yeah, we had like a pretty.
Yeah.
That. Yeah.
I'm trying to see what some people are asking just because.
Pilot lives in the woods now. What did you do to him? Oh my God, I did nothing. Now I clearly rewatched. He was evil.
Can you say rock?
Say rock. Huh?
What? How did I say
before? Raquel.
Oh. Raquel.
Raquel.
Yeah, Raquel.
Oh, that's funny. Please share.
What is do you Tessa want married?
I don't know.
Do you still think? Yeah.
Sold that on Poshmark. I'm just kidding. So horrible.
A lot of like backlash after the show at all?
Oh, yeah. I am. So I went to college at Pepperdine, and my first day, people were saying, even though, you know, that's such a great, it's again, a really small school, really right. great school, but people were giving me like, you know, so much shit. And so I didn't even rush it. I didn't rush a sorority my freshman year. In fact, at all my entire 4 years, basically because like the social anxiety. Yeah. No one would have wanted me anyway at that point, but, no, but it caused like a lot of social anxiety, I'd say.
Yeah.
For me.
Yeah.
Because people automatically had this like preconceived notion of you, and that's not right. actually how we were. So.
Yeah.
I don't care.
That's you.
Yeah, no, I didn't. I mean, I think because it was like, you know, your truth and you know, like,
that's true.
Yeah. I don't know why it was like, so because of what you saw on the episodes, it was so far from, I think, the truth. Like, even like there's little glaring when you were doing a live the other day, it was so funny. I was showing my boyfriend what a live was. And then you guys were live and like watching season 3. And then it was so funny. The one thing that I saw, and I told Cami we needed to like Hulu the episodes because there's so many episodes that I don't even think we watched.
No, it's not on Hulu.
It's not.
You'll have to buy it off iTunes.
Okay, good. We wrote a strongly worded letter to Hulu and they took it down then. But there's like a lot that happened, like certain glares that we were making or certain things that we were saying about people that it never even was about that person. So I think for us, it's like you have to like remember like that didn't happen that way. It was all editing.
Yeah. And what if you, I always say this, I'm like, if I was edited at 16, it would be awful.
Right.
Yeah.
So I'm sure, like I said, I'm sure everyone has, like, over the course of 9 months of just having, saying probably horrible things, and just most people don't have a camera following them around, and having it sliced and diced and then shown to the entire basically world, which is forever imprinted at everyone, these 16, awkward 16-year-olds who are just total brats, seemed like.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Do you still keep in contact with a lot of people you were friends with in high school?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, not so much about people that were on the show.
Mm-hmm.
I think Lexi, and through Instagram, it's like we know everything that's going on in somebody's life, but they're not, you know, we're not super close with everybody. Lexi
and
was
Rachel.
So close with
her. I'm good friends with Rachel, and then also Candace, who was on there as well.
Okay.
Who else?
Does anyone have babies? Yeah, Cami has a baby. Tasha Rain.
Yeah.
Yeah, Rachel. Okay. Rachel.
How was prom with Jason, Cami?
I don't even remember, to be honest. I think all the red cups that you saw on TV, we all knew what was in them. But no, it's so funny that that whole thing made so much of a bigger deal. Even like, again, people still ask me. It was fun. I mean, he was always fun. Jason was a great guy.
Yeah.
And now he's doing fantastic. He has a beautiful baby.
Mm-hmm. He's sober.
Sober, yeah.
So I'm sorry. I'm like trying. People wanted me to prepare questions, so I really tried.
Oh no.
Do you guys like? Are you ever recognized still from being on Laguna?
Yeah.
And is it like usually?
Especially when we're together.
Yeah.
More than like we feel like
and I was also part. Like the only like vaguely ethnic person on that show, so for me I was like, yeah, of course they're like, Lord, I think they're gonna remember me probably the most. But yeah, no, we still do from time to time. And sometimes people awkwardly, it's happened once when I went with my daughter actually out, and someone was like talking to me for a while, and they're like, I just want to say, like, it's, I'm so happy to find out that like you're actually not a bitch. I'm like, wow.
I think I said that to Kyndra in a message. I'm like, oh, it's nice you guys are like down to earth and cool.
Not horrible people.
Are you guys still living in Laguna?
No, I live in Corona del Mar,
which is
literally 5 minutes north
basically.
Of Laguna.
And I live up in LA.
Oh, okay. That's awesome.
Yeah.
Yeah. I've never been to California. I heard it's beautiful though.
Where are you?
So I'm originally from Boston, but I just moved to Nashville.
Okay, so what's the obsession with Laguna Beach? Is it okay to call it that?
Yeah,
or infatuation?
Me and my friends, we always just like, it was like a cult classic in my friend group. Like we just quote it and all this stuff. And one night we were drinking and I'm like, I'm going to make a page called Laguna Beach.
Oh my God, I love it.
And then I did.
And here we are.
Exactly.
Okay, sorry.
That's okay. But yeah, I feel like such a weirdo talking to you guys sometimes, but I'm like, no, I'm really not like that crazy.
Yeah, no, I don't think so. No.
Are you guys still friends with, they want to know if you're still friends with Nikki.
Friendly, yeah.
I haven't seen her in like years, but not like not friends, but we just don't ever really see her.
Yeah.
And I think it's hard for people to be like, 11 years goes by. A lot's changed in people's lives. And
yeah. So one of my friends, she's the one who introduced me to Laguna and bought Laguna season 3 for me. She goes, it's nostalgic. I'm like, yeah, that's it. It's nostalgic.
Yeah, there you go. Like
exactly.
Well, you guys paid for it, right?
Yeah, but when it comes down to it, I think it was like my dad did the math and it was like we got like 9 cents an hour for how much we filmed.
That is for 9 months, yeah.
Yeah.
And like I when I talk to Jessica and Alex, I'm like, these Teen Mom 2 girls are making like insane money.
Oh my God, we were way too soon.
Yeah,
it was really truly one of the first like real reality TV shows, with the exception of like Real World and like Road Rules before any like the.
It was the
else.
First like drama series.
Docudrama.
Do you guys, or would you ever do more reality TV, like now that you're older?
I feel like, especially now that we've done it and we've lived through that, it's like, you know exactly, I mean, not exactly, I'm sure you'd still mess up, but it was a big learning experience for us. So I never say never, but.
So we actually, right after the show filmed, we were working with actually somebody from Laguna and kind of a production crew. We filmed a pilot for a show. And then when we were in talks with a couple different networks, we had decided like, we both wanted to go to college. Like, let's not do this. We already kind of had like a bad taste in our mouths from it.
So too soon.
It was way too soon. We had some time. And, you know, we've considered it again and whatnot, but we'll see.
Yeah. That's a normal.
Maybe we'll be the new, like, Kathy Lee and Hoda.
Oh.
That would be hysterical.
Yeah, but Hoda just got promoted. She took Matt Lauer's place.
That would
Kathy
be awesome.
Lee drunk somewhere on a beach.
Doesn't sound so bad.
Mm-hmm.
They said release the pilot on YouTube.
Oh.
It was like forever ago, and then someone probably was like, nah, that's too scary.
We probably have it in an email, actually. The link?
No. On my, like, where? Hotmail account? We'll try and find it. We should find it.
That'd be great. Yeah. So, you guys have been friends for a long time, so that was all just natural, like, no production forcing you guys to hang out.
No.
Yeah, no.
We've been best friends since we were 11.
She's technically, like, a Mayo.
Yeah.
But did they like go to certain parties to create conflict and stuff, or
there's certain, like, not all the time, there's certain stuff that, like, sure, we're not gonna
we were highly encouraged to show up places, and it's like, it, at the time, it's like you're 16 and it's almost like your boss telling you should show up somewhere.
Mm-hmm.
Make sure that you're checking in this person to get mic'd. It's not completely like Cami and I care to go to Raquel's Christmas party.
Or talk about them even.
Yeah.
So yeah, that might have been another thing with filming.
Forced.
Like, okay, we're gonna basically do recap or talk about this party, and meanwhile we didn't really care to discuss it because nothing really that interesting happened. But it was so, like, that conversation would start going, and you know, we were.
And I think that like how they tried to tie it in season 3 to season 2 was with Brianna Conrad, and I think it was that was their way with Tessa and Raquel, because it was somebody that they were friends with her, and we weren't, not that we weren't friendly with them, but it was just two different groups. So I think they were really trying to force that conflict.
Yeah, it wasn't as organic or anything like that.
Yeah.
How do you guys pronounce
Raquel?
Someone actually asked, do you guys remember what your AIM screen name was?
Yeah. Kamala Lee 099.
Okay. I don't remember mine. That was a joke one that we did to mess with people. No.
Surf Big Wave.
I don't remember mine.
Wait,
why?
Is I don't know.
Around?
Nostalgia. It's all about nostalgia.
Oh, okay. Yeah, for sure.
What was it? Now I want to know.
Well, like, okay, I went back and watched your live and, like, our Cabo episode, like, to show, well, we're not going to discuss Cabo, but to say one thing about, like, just the editing, we weren't leaving Cabo, and they forced us to grab empty suitcases and stand at the front to have a scene for an hour.
And I think we were even, like, I didn't watch that part, rewatch that recently, but, like, I think we were, like, snippy with each other, kind of.
Because we were so irritated.
We were so annoyed that because we were, like, hungover.
We had empty suitcases.
Yeah.
That's annoying.
Stuff like that.
Yeah. So
sorry if you're watching MTV.
So yeah, Cabo seems to be the worst episode for everyone to talk to.
Yeah, it was not.
Are you kind of happy that social media wasn't like huge when you guys were on?
I think it's like a catch-22. I don't know. I mean, at parts, like, I think now if you look at it, like, all these people that, like, really take this opportunity, if you're given a platform like that and run with it, and, like, they do a lot of good, they create businesses, where it was for us, it was like, we had, I think, MySpace, like, a few years later, and that was it.
Yeah.
So I don't know. I think if at 16, market ourselves and actually have an idea of what we wanted to do in business, but, you know, it's definitely kind of, like, forgotten.
Yeah. No.
On Laguna Beach.
Yes, Laguna Beach is trying to keep it alive. I'm just hoping that
keep it alive.
Yeah, doesn't come out for live stream their content.
Yeah. And I think, like, so somebody said, like, Kristen made herself successful. And I think, like, that was really, like, the big thing for her was that she had the hills that, you know, continued that.
Yeah, definitely.
Yeah.
Did you go to your high school reunion?
No. I was actually, it was Thanksgiving weekend. I was out of town. I went to Palm Springs.
We were busy.
No, I think we were both out of town, maybe.
Yeah.
I didn't go to my high school reunion either, so it's fine. So season two, Cami, you were in that episode where, like, Jason scared you. Were you guys actually scared?
Oh.
Do you remember that?
We were at Morgan's house. You weren't with me. Oh, yeah. No, they did, actually. So that was before that. So season two was, yes, pre, like, almost fabricating as much as they possibly could to the situation. But I'm sure that, like, yeah, I totally forgot about that. That's I didn't funny. Even know that. Oh, yeah. We were at Morgan. I was at Morgan Souter's house.
Mm-hmm.
And, yeah, he came out of, like, the wood. Because her house is, like, kind of up against a hill. And, yeah, he
don't give the address.
Yeah.
No, don't give the address.
I don't even know it. I don't even know her parents' home address. Thank God, or else I probably would accidentally say it. Yeah, he came out of the woods and completely scared the crap out of us. I completely forgot about that. We need to rewatch season two, too.
Mm-hmm. Oh, okay.
You're in it a lot, Cami.
Am I really?
Well, you're the one during dinner, like, Cami walked in on Jason and Jessica.
Oh, you should start. Trying to make a name for herself.
Were you guys approached to be the narrator? Or was it always going to be Tessa? Do you know? Or
so funny enough, I actually, because we're still with a couple of the producers for MTV. For Laguna, we actually had lunch with one of them last week, and we were talking about it, and he had said, you know, he pushed hard for, along with, what are you guys doing? Pushed hard to get Kendra and I as, like, or actually Kendra is the narrator. She has more of the story and whatnot. But for some reason, some of, like, the higher level people were like, no, we want this, we want it, instead of having the, like, I mean, no offense to everybody else, but, like, the more outgoing, sort of, like, lively type of person leading the conversation, like Kristen or even, like, Lauren did the previous seasons, would have been Kendra, but instead they were, like, they wanted to try something else, and I think that ultimately, I mean, from what I've heard, that wasn't probably the best plan that they had.
Any of the lives, yeah, it's definitely not the best choice.
Yeah, so I mean, they always had us doing all, and afterwards, I think they kind of had realized they had made that mistake when they had were sending us out to doing all of, like, the post interview, like, you know, post series interviews, or even, you know, magazine shoots and stuff like that. Because, yeah, I think together we've been best friends for so long, we're pretty good together on camera, and we can carry a conversation. I think at that point, maybe they weren't as savvy on camera when it comes
to as comfortable or something.
Yeah,
you two should definitely, like, host a podcast or something.
So my mom's over, and that's what she just said. She's making a margarita right now, actually. It's 4 o'clock.
She's filming us like this, telling us we're doing good job, sweetie.
So cute. Yeah.
Here, Mom, say hi.
Oh, my God. Hello.
Hi.
Happy Monday.
Happy Monday to you, too.
Yeah.
Meanwhile, I'm, like, trying to tell my parents, I'm like, I'm doing this really cool live interview. They're like, what's it? I'm like, cool.
Just trust me. It's really cool.
It's a big deal, Mom. It's a big deal.
Yeah, exactly. So I'm just trying to read some more comments from fans. Me so many.
Remember your mom's date with Cameron?
Oh, my gosh, that's funny. They remembered you from the date with Cameron. That was also Forrest. It's like, and it was never the timing of him and Jessica, like, that whole thing was so not true. But Jessica was really, like, still on wanting to be on season three. I don't know why was she on season three? That's so weird. Because
so I did a live. She was my first live. She agreed to, like, do one. And I asked her, and she's like, I don't even know what happened with that.
Agreed.
Yeah.
I don't even think anything.
We didn't know about it until it was, like, we saw it on TV.
Interesting. Yeah.
What are you doing here? Yeah.
Someone wants to know if your mom went to Cabo with you.
Yeah.
You're doing great, honey. That's what you do. Yeah, no, my mom was in Cabo. And my dad.
And those are virgin margaritas.
And they're virgin margaritas, she says.
Absolutely.
For sure.
You just act like that all the time, right?
No, I'm just kidding. Oh, yeah.
What's your favorite memory from filming? Do you have, like,
I know what you're going to say.
What, the
We did a lot that didn't air, and I think that, you know, we had like these parties at our house. We had an entire trip that didn't air, and really was the entire cast that went to Big Bear, and we, you know, had a weekend up there, and it never made it to TV. But
because somebody caught on fire, right?
Oh, no one caught on fire, Karen.
Yeah, it was a fire.
No, there was no fire. I think that for the most part, to be like super general, just having like our funny moments, because there was a lot of laughter, but we've had like crazy parties at our house.
I don't remember. Yeah, it was, we had a couple like themed parties that never made it because they were like, we can't actually put that on TV.
Oh, like the white
trash. We had a white trash party. And I think and so we all dressed up like kind of like hillbillies, if you will, kind of. We had like KFC. It was just really like stuff that like should not be on TV for season. It made us look horrible. And so they even tried to push us to do a different theme, and we're like, nope, we're doing it. And then they never aired it. So
yeah.
But then the next year they put on like 16 and Pregnant. So I don't know why.
I know, right? Currently, that's acceptable.
I know.
We were a gateway drug.
Yeah.
Up the gates for sure.
Exactly.
Do you have any moments that like you really regret being filmed? Is it Cabo? Because for Jessica and Alex, it was Cabo, and I know you're not going to talk a lot about Cabo.
No, we could talk about Cabo.
We were kidding.
Yeah, no, I was just kidding. Yeah, probably just. I think. I mean, and it's no secret that we were drinking. I think that not knowing your limits at 16. I think drinking on camera is ever like that's a horrible idea. Yeah. But especially when you're 16 and in Cabo, not my best moment.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I don't know if I was ever mean to anyone on camera.
I think they've edited. Yeah, they've edited, so it looks like we're like laughing about somebody or something like that, and it's not that at all. And yeah, there's some stuff that we said even now that I think is, or like rewatching it, you're like, oh, that actually was mean. Don't get me wrong, the stuff that we said, some of it was mean, but also some of it was like, could have been about somebody else. I don't even know. We don't even, rewatching it, we've slowly tried to like do it. But yeah.
Well, it's okay. I mean, 16, everyone's mean. It's right. High school. That's it.
Are we married? No, we're not married, but we might have a common law marriage between the two of us. So.
Did you go to church after you sinned?
Oh my God.
That's a quote from you, right?
Oh yeah, after winter formal.
Yeah.
I don't think I went. But I've been since then, so yeah, sure. I went. Do I still have the ring?
Were
what
there
ring?
Any, I don't know. Did Taylor get you a ring?
Yeah, the David German ring.
Oh, wow, way to keep us honest, Karen.
She sold that on Poshmark as well.
I was like, I don't know.
Right?
People keep asking about Cameron and Tyler.
Yeah, a lot of people are asking about Cameron and Tyler.
Last time I lost
honestly haven't seen. Does he live here? He might live in LA.
I don't know.
I think he's doing acting now. I think you can find him on Instagram. Do you follow him?
Yeah. I think following him.
Yeah, I think he's doing acting now, but we don't really like talk to. I haven't talked to him in years. And Tyler, I think somebody. Is that gonna fall?
Probably.
Somebody told us that it looks like he's in a forest somewhere.
I think he's in Alaska and he chops a lot of wood, from what I can tell.
You follow him? Oh my gosh, that's interesting.
My mom's still really close with his mom.
Nikki's mom.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
Is Tessie your hairdresser?
No. David.
So you guys were, freshman and sophomore when, like, 1 and 2 were being filmed? Is that right?
Yeah.
Yeah.
So was it kind of cool, like, knowing all the gossip before it ended up on MTV? Or
yes and no, because you never know what they're, like, how they're going to twist it and how they're going to, like, portray things.
Mm-hmm.
But I think by, like, the time it got to season 3, like, people, and especially, like, because of the success of season 1 and 2, I think, like, a lot of these people, like, we actually had to try out for it. Like, we had to go to a hotel, and we went through, like, series of interviews. I think people were really desperate to try to get on TV.
Yeah.
But I think that, like, there was something just very organic about 1 and 2.
Yeah, and were people, like, jealous you guys got picked and they didn't, or did that not really?
I don't think so, no. I mean, there was some people, I wouldn't call it necessarily.
We only had 800 people in our school, though.
I wouldn't call it jealous, but people definitely were like mean about it, I'd say.
Yeah.
Not like, again, I don't think it's like a jealousy thing. It's more like.
And people, some people were really anti the show because of how Laguna was this really small community. This really small art town, and that like really the show is bringing so many tourists and so much awareness about Laguna.
Oh, wait, hold on. I want to address that. Why did you stop talking to Tessa when she got sick and what was her sickness?
I didn't. That was really wrong.
It was a lie on her part. It was the most bizarre thing.
Okay. Tessa said that I stopped being. What?
I said, do you want to clear the air?
Yeah, so I was friends with Tessa when we were in, like, soccer, so, like, elementary school. Our phone's dying, but we weren't close through middle school, and then by the time we got to high school, we weren't friends at all. So not that there's anything, you know, wrong with our friendship of what happened, but we just weren't friends. So for her come her junior and senior year to say that she had gotten sick and that's why I stopped being friends with her, that's like the craziest, horrible, fabricated lie ever. So
yeah, that's pretty awful.
And I don't even know what her sickness was. I think she got a skin disease from going. But this was years after I was friends with her. So I mean, that was another way of that she's like plot twisting.
Yeah.
That was one thing that was not like MTV made up. That was like she made that up.
Yeah.
Which is,
but again, people are desperate to be on TV.
That's surprising. She didn't seem like she even wanted to be there.
She didn't seem like she wanted to be there.
So did anyone like change when cameras turned on them? Like when they were on, when they were on camera, do you think like anyone really changed?
Unfortunately, no. Everybody was like kind of themselves. And for the most part, right? Yeah, God, it's been so long. My mom changed, actually. My mom is like the funniest person in the world, and then when she'd get on camera, she'd be like so awkward and like sit there and then like be like I'm gonna go wash the dog. It's like, okay. That's the only person in my life that was really changed by it.
I think that I don't know. I mean, yeah, I wouldn't say that we like changed how we were, but I'd say that we, you know, again, they asked us to talk about certain things that we wouldn't normally be talking about, or like people, like, again, we wouldn't spend our time talking about like Tessa or Raquel. It was like they had asked that we do that.
She's doing yoga.
Like right now, for example, Kendra's mom's doing yoga
with
like
a margarita in her hand. Legitimately,
that's perfect. She should do a live too.
I know. You're next to do a live, mom.
It was so funny. I was asking people during a live. I'm like, who do you want to see next to, like, Cami and Kyndra? I'm like, I will do my best.
Oh, we're so excited to be able to do it with you.
I know. This is so much fun. I'm just trying to meet other people. Who were you friends with from earlier season? Like, from 1 and 2?
We kind of grown up with them for the most part. But not super close, I would say, with any of them. Like Morgan, we were friendly with. My sister was friends with Alex and Kristen for a while, but then I think they had some drama with a boyfriend.
Spill the tea.
Courtney, do you want to say what happened with you and Kristen?
Oh.
Courtney?
Mm-hmm. Oh. What's up, guys? Sorry, I'm like eating a burrito bowl. It's so bad.
No, fine. Why wasn't Courtney on season two? Because I always said if they had her, it would have been like a more organic transition season three.
Yeah, I think that they've kind of tried that with Lauren, with Brianna.
Yeah.
It didn't really work well. Yeah. Yeah.
What are these questions? I don't know. I'm trying to read.
I know. You can go through and read some fan questions if you want.
I know. There's so many.
Oh.
Why weren't more of the parents on the show?
A lot of parents weren't happy with the show.
Yeah.
So a lot of parents just didn't appear basically because of that. A lot.
And I think that MTV really wanted to like portray that like we didn't have parents and that we were like spoiled children that like were these crazy, you know, beach homes and that we didn't have parental supervision.
Yeah.
But like the Cabo episode, like right when that all started, like you could see my parents sitting with us, you know, at the hotel like that night. So like mm-hmm. our parents were definitely around.
Yeah.
How do I know Brendan Fitzpatrick? Oh, I know Brendan from somebody else from, if I know Brendan, how I know Brendan from, I actually met him in Vegas. And we just remained friends.
We want your yoga doing margarita drinking mama.
I know, right? Hers is the next live. And sorry, we're so close right now. The phone is dying.
That's okay.
No, I didn't.
What's going on with Brianna now? I'm not sure. Mm-hmm. I don't know.
Do you know where Brianna is? You might know.
No.
Really?
I've never like looked into where she is. I don't know.
Where's Tessa now?
I know she's a hairdresser.
Okay. Oh, Cami told me that Raquel had a baby and named it Khaleesi.
Yep.
So there's that.
Yep.
That's cool.
Like from Game of Thrones.
Sure to do a live. I don't think she's gonna do a live.
Oh. Yeah.
Okay. Have any of your outfits?
Oh my god. Well, I'm a hoarder, so I probably do have all of my outfits.
I dumped it all.
My sister's selling all my stuff on Poshmark right now.
What's your Poshmark?
At Maywoo.
At Maywoo. Because I literally keep all of my stuff. I had her come over yesterday.
I'll have her sign the bottom of the Louboutins. We do a very special deal. Put it in a bundle, 10% off.
Yeah, sounds good. What kind of drugs is Raquel on?
Oh, I literally thought there was.
I'm from Africa. Oh, that's crazy.
Yeah.
We're in Laguna right now. Oh, she lives near Laguna.
Corona Del Mar, which is close.
Bring Juicy back.
Bring Juicy back. Yeah.
Were you guys team Kristen or team Elsie, or were you team no one?
Team Kristen. Wait, from what was their fight with like Steven?
Oh, Steven.
Or Brody?
I feel like they just didn't like each other. Steven.
It's the only way to say his name.
Yeah, no, I think team Kristen over team, I mean, if I had to pick.
I guess. I don't know. Yeah.
Kristen has a personality.
Yeah.
Yeah.
My family's weighing in. Yeah.
Yes, everyone's commenting Tasha Rain. She's become pretty popular.
Yeah, I, like, just recently had heard about that.
Heard about
I experienced any racism while during the show. I didn't, but I definitely got some of, like, some women saying that I'm sorry, women be saying that I act too white, which is pretty offensive because what does acting white mean? I am three quarters white. I am equipped to make me one or the other more than the other. I'm like, I'm trying to think of what that actually means. Is it the way that I dress? Is it the way that I speak? You know, so I was kind of offended, but you know, people will say mean things, but in general, yeah, it's probably one of the few. Again, whiter or darker than, you know, Kendra-ish in Laguna, people that they're actually, you know, there's not a ton to be completely honest, so.
Yeah.
Preach. Woo! Yeah. Queen of racism clapbacks.
Yeah.
No, you guys are awesome for this live, because some people aren't willing to really answer too many questions. So I really appreciate it. I appreciate you guys doing this.
Of course. Wait, do people say I'm not answering that? Should we have said that?
No, not you guys. Other people.
Okay.
Yeah.
We didn't know that was an option.
No, you have to answer every single question.
Everything. Okay, perfect.
Cami, was Jason the worst date ever? We already talked about prom, so you don't have to answer that. Were you guys upset there was no season 4? Like, were you heartbroken like me? Or
no, based on how they like really had season 3 go, we were like kind of relieved because season 3 was not good. It wasn't good TV.
And not only that, but again, of like how, especially towards the end of how we, after we watched all the episodes, we were kind of like, screw this. Like, wasn't, again, as we said 50 times already, that's not us. It was like, yeah, so much editing done and so many.
But I thought it was really desperate that they tried to go to Newport to do that show.
Yeah.
It was horrible.
Yeah.
Weird.
I agree with that. Everyone keeps asking if I'm going to post about it. I'm like, no.
Yeah, I couldn't even tell you one person's name from that show. There's Newport, Newport Harbor. I know.
Exactly.
Exactly. People don't know about it. Our peanut gallery back here didn't know.
We paid her to say that.
What was your favorite song that played at prom? The Hillary Duff, Let the Rain Fall In?
Come and Clean.
Yeah, Come Clean. Is that what it is? Come Clean?
Yeah.
Oh.
That was your, that's the intro to Laguna.
Yeah, that's our favorite song.
All day.
Fuck, Mary Kill. Wait, oh. You do that. I don't do that.
No.
You don't, you have Mary- if you don't want.
Yeah. The men in your season.
Why did I move to LA? I moved to LA for college. I went to Pepperdine.
She comes down and sees me though often.
I do.
Right? Come to Africa, I'll take care of you. Oh, okay. So we're going to Africa.
That's actually what we're up to. We're moving to Africa now.
Yeah.
The test scene was the best.
It was the worst scene.
Well, if you guys come to Nashville, we'll tear it up on Broadway.
Oh yeah. Wait, can we come? When is like the big country? Isn't there a big country music award there? We're coming in June. Is it in June?
I don't know. I just moved here. I don't even
know. Oh, country. Are you into country?
No.
Oh, what are you doing in Nashville?
I came here
it's
in
the
July.
Wrong place.
I came here in July and had so much fun and I'm like, I'm gonna move here.
Oh my gosh, you're so spontaneous.
I'm really.
You met a cowboy?
Huh?
Have you met a cowboy?
No. Luckily for me, most of the guys I meet are just kind of passing through, so no commitment.
Just for the night.
Yeah.
Passing through.
Yeah.
That's funny. Oh, was your sister at Harvest 91? Yes, she was there. And thank God she's over here now. She's here.
Yeah.
I don't know.
Is your public?
Thanks for asking.
Do you guys watch any reality TV shows? Do you have any favorite like reality shows now?
I honestly do, and I feel so dirty for saying that I watch reality TV, but I feel like the news is so depressing and it's so like horrifying of what our world is right now. So I watch reality TV because you don't have to think.
No, I agree.
It's like kind of like tune out dumb TV. It's almost like therapy. It's like, okay, it's, I don't know. It's horrible to say that, but you know, I watch like the Housewives.
I don't.
I know I do.
I've never seen a Housewives episode.
Oh, really?
Okay, now I feel really bad.
I'm like, I don't watch The Bachelor. I watch Teen Moms, but that's it.
Do you really? See, I don't watch that. I don't watch Teen Mom. I'll watch like the Housewives of Beverly Hills. That's, I don't even like the Orange County one. Beverly Hills.
Yeah. I only watch that because I'm like, okay, let me just watch like Amber and see how she's doing. And then I'll feel better.
Because we care how she's doing.
Yeah.
Wait, it's funny to think like how like, crazy those people are paid now, huh?
Like $200,000, yeah.
Like, what the actual fuck? That's crazy. For being pregnant at 16.
I mean, no one paid me to get pregnant.
Yeah, I paid you. It's my child. Her child's actually sleeping upstairs right now in my house. That shows you she's my baby.
And now they just sell fit tea, fit tea.
Yeah, like, who's going to pay us to carry a fit tea? Like, what?
You're verified now. They'll pay you.
Oh, okay, girl.
I'm hoping I'm verified soon. Jeez, jealous.
I love it. Luca wants a shout out from Parker Hooker.
Sidia, hi. Sorry.
No, that's Fine. People keep asking to spill the tea about Brianna, but you said you don't know.
Like, no. No, I don't know. I think she's in somewhere in Laguna or ish Orange County area. No, I don't think so. I'm friends with her like on Instagram and Facebook. And
oh, then you know everything. Pull up the phone. We'll find out. Don't worry. I think I'm friends with her on Facebook and Instagram, but I just don't know.
Wait, don't
I don't follow
you
her.
Follow her, yeah?
No.
No? Brianna?
No, I don't.
Hold, please.
Some people I don't follow because I don't care.
Yeah.
I'll take a look.
We'll get back to you on that.
Okay.
Sorry, Kyndra's pulling back in. Yeah, we'll get back to you on that.
I'll take a look. We'll get back to you on that.
Okay, Courtney.
Oh, Courtney's Googling it. Wow.
Oh, hey.
Thanks for the support.
Siesta Key? I don't know what Siesta Key
is. Oh, Siesta Key is the, like, it's a new show.
Yeah.
Did you watch it?
I was going to.
Is it like a Laguna?
One of the cast members, like, did animal cruelty to a shark and, like, dragged.
Oh, yeah.
So I was like.
And no. They aired
Jordan,
it?
Our friend Jordan is behind us, told us about that.
No, they didn't air that, but it got, like, viral on Facebook or something, and I was just.
Oh, that's
he
horrible.
Shot a shark, like, with a gun, right?
And dragged it behind a boat or something.
Oh, my gosh. I saw that video. And they were, like, there was this crazy something of trying to get him arrested, right?
And then another thing, too, which I was told, was that, you know, one of the dads, I don't know if it's the same kid who got in trouble, but one of their dads was basically the money behind the production for the – he basically paid for them to have a show.
Oh.
And then sold it. I don't know. Maybe that's –
rich kid.
Info that I don't repeat, but
no, I don't care for that show. I tried to watch it and I'm like, this is awful.
Yeah.
Everyone keeps saying you look like Morgan Stewart. Who that is. Kyndra.
Oh, my sister says that.
Morgan's is
she was on the that's Brendan's wife, but she was on the my God, help me out.
Rich Kids of Beverly
Hills.
Oh, okay.
Thank you. I think she's gorgeous. So thanks. I'll take it.
How was it?
One of the nicer things I've heard.
Kyndra, Jason's birthday dinner on the hills. Do you remember it? How was it being on the hills?
I mean, it was like being at a dinner. They just filmed it. You know?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Jordan, you're texting me, but I can't read it. What are you saying? We have a few girlfriends over and they're texting me, but I
can't read it.
Read
it.
Is Avery at your home? And she's right here.
Pouring more wine.
So many people think you look like Morgan Stewart.
I know. So what's the best memory of like senior year? Something that wasn't filmed. Do you have anything about that?
Senior year?
I'm sure Morgan appreciates
what was the better thing of senior year that happened for us?
Do you get your car?
Breaking up with Tyler? Breaking up with Tyler and leaving him in the woods. I'm just kidding.
Chop wood.
She did that to him.
No, I didn't.
It's all her fault.
Oh, yeah, it's my fault. Yeah. Courtney, people are writing, what did you do to
11
him?
11 years later, he's still
now
he's
suffering.
All he's
suffering.
All messed up because
but you don't cheat on people. Yeah.
Did the show ruin high school for you guys, do you think? Like, did it ruin your senior year, or?
No. Senior year, it was like, and it's so funny, though, I saw something about it, some teachers on there, but yeah, some of the teachers were actually, like, kind of, a couple of them were kind of rude, to be honest with you. They were, like, treated you a little differently.
Like, you're exposing.
Yeah.
That's weird.
It was, that was maybe like, a little bit weird, but
I said it's probably worse. Nostalgic. I already did.
Instagram's gonna kick us off in like 10 minutes.
Okay, what other final questions do you have?
So I asked Alex and Jessica this, so I'm gonna ask you guys. If you could go back and give yourself like any advice during filming, what would it be?
Not to film.
I think that my mom just said not to film.
She's pouring the tequila back into the bottle.
Legit. Ultimately, that's happening right now. I think for me, like, don't worry so much of, like, for not during the filming, but after, like, don't worry so much of what people think, because I was, like, really, like, kind of, like, embarrassed of, like, doing any sort of appearances and, like, embracing the show at all. Mm-hmm. Like, you kind of, like, wanted to downplay it instead of, like, embracing it.
Yeah.
But so I'm just having your regrets of filming. I have regrets of the editors. And like,
okay.
But like, they really kind of butchered it.
Yeah. And I'm just saying, yeah. Instagram kicks you off after an hour doing live, so that's why.
We've been doing this an hour?
Just about, yeah.
Wow.
4:54. Oh my gosh.
God, we don't.
Shut up, do we? No, it's fine.
Yes, I do remember going to the after show in Toronto. That was the most, like, nerve-wracking experience. It's so funny. We've been told, you know, like, the U.S., like, people were a lot bigger fans for season three of, like, from what I've heard, like, Raquel or, like, Tessa, let's say. And in Canada, they apparently loved Kyndra and I, so they had invited us both. She couldn't go, but I went and hosted the live finale there, I think, or something, the after
I
show.
I couldn't go to Canada for some reason. They didn't allow me in. I don't
know why. Oops. But yeah, no, that was a lot of fun in Canada.
So, same question for you, Cam. What advice would you give, like, a younger you for filming, or even in general?
I probably would have said, you know, again, we were led into a lot of, like, the conversation that we had and talking about people, and I think I would have probably stopped myself from doing what they kind of had asked. Certain mm-hmm. stuff where I'm like, don't get me wrong, we said those things, we did, most of them, with heavy editing, but there's certain stuff where I was like, you know, well, how do you feel about this? And I really had no opinion whatsoever, and it wasn't like a made-up opinion, but again, it was sort of like a forced response of force, like, discussion, us talking about these people, and I wish that I had not, sorry, Kendra's mom's messing with the lights, I wish that I had not, you know, even engaged with that and just told the producers or whoever was filming us at the time, like, you know, I'm not even gonna comment on that. So there's certain stuff that I kind of wish I didn't say. Wait, but at the same time, oh, what?
Someone sorry, said, how did you become friends with Jordan Muse?
Did we wear the same last week?
Jordan
is
best
friend.
Sister is here, and
there.
And then Jordan's daughter and my daughter are
That's how we became friends. No, they met in college. My sister and Jordan met in college, like 12 years ago.
Mm-hmm. Your daughters are friends. But we guys sound like a couple.
I said, and now our daughters are friends.
Thank God I went to
college. Wait, thanks
once.
For saying I look young.
Thanks for the social media. Oh, yeah.
Thanks.
Talk about Kyndra's style. Her bedroom was goals.
Oh, my 16-year-old bedroom? The leper? Yikes. Any other questions?
They wanted to show Kristen and Courtney, but she doesn't have to say it if she doesn't want to.
Oh, maybe stay tuned.
What was the question?
Of why you're not friends with Kristen. Or what happened with you and Kristen?
I made a permanent decision on a temporary emotion. She had slept with my high school boyfriend, and so I had slashed her tires, and it's something I will never forgive myself for. I'm very
well. And then there's that.
I think you can say that, Courtney. Say that.
Save lives?
Yeah.
No, like, not like lives, but like people's lives. Like you could save like,
a story. Story in like forever.
No, it's only up 24 hours.
Okay, well, and my mom just said it's been over 7 years of the statute of limitations, so we're good on that.
Yeah.
And we're not accessory. We're not going to make you an accessory, don't worry.
I don't think Kristen's going to watch my live, so don't worry.
Okay.
I'm like 90% sure.
Then it's a Courtney problem, not an us problem anyway.
Courtney is a savage. That's funny.
Your sister's gangster.
She actually does live in Laguna Beach, not Laguna Beach.
What?
She like legitimately lived in Laguna Beach, not Laguna Beach.
She helped
with
5 after that. I did her a favor.
Oh, my God.
I appreciate that. Okay, so before this kicks us off.
Yeah. Any other things you want to add? I mean, you kind of answered.
No, this was so fun, and thanks for keeping the nostalgia of Laguna Beach still going.
I know. Absolutely. And seriously, when you come to Nashville, let me know.
We're coming in June for the country, whatever they do.
That thing
that they do with country, and we're doing that.
Okay, well, I won't be there, but I can meet you after.
Why? You live in Nashville.
I know. I should really get into country music.
Yeah. Luke Bryan, start with him.
Okay. I like
that. It's a good gateway drug.
Jason Aldean and... Sam.
Yeah, another good gateway drug.
Yeah, yeah, for sure.
You don't like country, I know.
Sam Hunt.
My friend actually just with Sam Hunt. Her boyfriend tours with him.
I'm sorry, what?
Oh,
my good friend moved down here too, and her boyfriend's like a guitar tech for Sam Hunt, Bruce Springsteen, like all these giant names.
That's amazing. Okay, so our next live is going to be with you, asking you the questions.
Well, thank you guys so much for doing this.
Thank you. It was so fun.
Yeah, do a podcast because you guys are hysterical.
Okay, we'll consider. We'll let you know first.
Okay, awesome. Well, all thank right. you guys for doing this, and thank your mom and sister for joining.
Oh, absolutely. All right, thanks.
Bye, have a good night.
Bye.